Next program is to make an ALP to count number of blank spaces, number of lines and occurrence of a particular character, of which we are gonna take input from a file .txt, and we need to use extern global keyboard keyword and also percent include. So let's start. The first line in this is extern keyword, extern file procedure. Extern is used to import specific procedure or variable into a ASM file from another ASM file. So the next keyword is global. Global is used to declare members which can be imported by other ASM files. Percent include is used to include a whole ASM file, everything about that file. So here we are including the macro ASM file. Macro ASM file contains all the procedures of reading, printing, opening a file, reading from a file, writing to a file, closing a file and exiting. For operations of file, I have already explained it in my previous video of DOS command of type copy and delete. These all files should be in the same folder so they can be accessed. Now next is section.data for displaying all the messages and defining the variables. Now this is section.bss. We use here we are declaring buffer length, file name, character, file handler and actual buffer length. Then next is global underscore start. We'll first print the program title, then we'll print the file message, enter the file name for string operation, then we'll read the file name by using read macro or macro.asm file. We'll pass the arguments. Then actual length of character dead is stored in RAX, which also includes the EOF character. So we are first decrementing RAX by 1. Now we move file name plus RAX position 0. So to know where our file actually ends, we are moving it into that. File name plus RAX equals to 0. Now we'll print the char message to and for asking user what he she wants to search. We'll get the input from the user by passing the char and 2 as an argument using the read macro. We'll then open the file by passing the file name. The file open, it returns the file handler into the RAX register, and when it is compared to -1H, if it is a -1H, then there is an error and the file is not opened. If there is no if the file is opened and it returns a successful handler, then we will move this handler to file handle variable. Now we will read from the file by passing the file handler, buffer and buffer length. Now we'll move RAX will contain the total number of characters read from that file. Now RAX will move this value into the A buffer length, and here we are not decrementing A buffer length by 1, because we also want to know when the file actually ends, because at the last line there will be always a slash end, so we are not decrementing it by 1 here. Now we call file procedure, which is in the another ASM file which we have included using the extern keyword. Now this is section.data. We have defined all the variables here and messages which we want to display. This is section.bss. There is S count, N count and C count for space, enter and character count respectively, and this is char answer, so to display it, actual number of count in decimal digits. Here we are defining file procedure global so it can be imported by the first ASM file. we are importing file handler char buffer and a buffer len from the first sm file. We are also including the macro.sm file in this. The another procedure is var macro. This is the main procedure. We are first XORing RAX, RBX, RCX and RSI 0. So char is the variable where we have taken the input from the user which character he wants to search in that file. We'll move that character into the BL register and we'll point RSI to the buffer. When we read from the file, we are putting the characters values into the buffer. Actual buffer length is the total number of characters read. We'll put that into RCX. That is the count of that, how much total number of characters are there. Now this is the again label. We'll first put the contents of RSI first character into the AL register. Now this is the first space. We compare the value with 20H. If it is 20H, we will increase the count of S count, that is space. If it is not, we'll jump to another case of new line. And if it is a space, we'll jump to next to increment to next byte. When it is a new line, we'll compare with 0H and increment the count if it is. Similarly for the character, if PL is equal to AL, it means the character which user has entered is equal to the character which is in the buffer, then we'll increase the count of character count. After it is done, we'll go to this next. We'll increase the RSI to point to another character in buffer and decrement the count. If the count in the register is not zero, we'll again jump to this again label and loop it until it is not over. Now we'll print the messages for total number of spaces, lines and characters. And after that, we're gonna call the display procedure for that. In display procedure, we need actual number of counts, so we need the answer in decimal. So we'll first point RSI to the char answer plus 3. Char answer plus 3, we are starting from the leftmost byte. So their total number or total 4 bytes in RX or in a register which can be pointed by RSI. So we are pointing it to the last one, and that's why we're using plus 3, which means that 0th, 1st, 2nd and 3rd byte. We'll put total number of count, that is 4. It means 4 digits can be seen. We'll put 0 into the RDX, making RDX 0, because result of a division is stored in RDX register. The next step is moving 10 by into RBX for making it decimal, and we use 16 for hex. We divide the RDX register by RBX and put the value into RDX register. This is the instruction what actually happens in division. RDX is implicit. Now we'll just add 30H to this DL register. 30H we are adding because this is the X2 ASCII char. If any ASCII value is there, if you want to convert into its corresponding BCD or hex, we just need to add 30H to any of this, so we'll get the corresponding ASCII value for that in decimals. Now we'll put this del into the RSI. RSI is pointing to this char answer plus 3, means the last byte. We'll move this value into that. That means the ASCII value of whatever it is. Now we'll decrement RSI. It will now point one byte previous to the third byte, that is second byte. And also decrement the count. If the count is not zero, we'll again move to this count label and repeat the step until it is not zero. Now the last line is print char answer 4. We'll print the total answer by using this macro. Now we'll see how the program actually runs. Now this is the file. Now this is my file.txt, where this is the message. There are 4 lines, and this is the total messages in that file. Now we'll run it. All the files will be in the same directory. We'll first compile the first SM file in which global underscore start is present, because our program starts from that. We'll first compile that. We'll then compile the second ASM file. Now we'll going to link these both files, ld-o space nickname to the combined file. Then object file of first ASM file and then the second ASM file. Then enter. Then we'll run it. Enter file name for string operation. We'll enter my file dot txt. We are searching character A. Total number of spaces are 0. Total lines are 4. Total number of character occurrences are 2. As in welcome, there are repetition of it only 2 times. So thank you. If you like the video, please like it and subscribe it.